Chad Saliga, I play drums for Black Star Riders.
It's Damon Johnson, guitar, Black Star Riders.
How does it feel to be part of this beautiful celebration of music?
Well, you know what's crazy, man? We had no idea really this was going on until about 11 o'clock this morning. And because we're literally in London just for a few days off between our festival tour dates this summer. So we were elated, especially when we found out we had friends that were playing tonight. The Mastodon guys, Clutch is playing. So it's great, man. I'm probably not the only person that said this, but now more than ever, you know, we need to be unified and just keep waving the flag. You know, there's an ebb and flow in what styles are popular with the kids these days. You know, rock is always going to be here, man, and such a great collection of bands tonight. All the people in the press here have been so supportive of all of us. So it's great, man, to have that community come together, kind of celebrate what's happening in an event like this. We're honored, man. We're honored to be a part of it.
Can you quantify what the spirit of metal is, what the true essence of metal music is?
It's all in the attitude, man. That's just one word, attitude. Lifestyle. Aggression.
How's life been on the road? You guys coming off the back of the UK and European tour. How's that been going for you?
Oh, it's been great, man. Been very blessed. Fans have been very respectful, and this is really, this tour is the first tour I ever did with the band. So it's just been great. Yeah, doing a lot of festivals coming up too, so come out and check it out.
I know you guys have got Rambling Man coming up in the summer. Are you excited for that?
Will be my first time, so yeah, I'm very excited for sure.
You know, the thing that we're excited about this summer is the fact that we've got three albums worth of material now to choose from and put a really special set list together. You know, we got a firsthand experience with that when we did our UK tour in March, and the reaction was just over the top, man. We could not have been happier with the support and the reaction from the fans. So, Rambling Man is going to be kind of the crown jewel on top of a really productive summer for Black Star Riders. So, we've actually got a couple surprises for that night. We want to really blow it out. It's going to be we've got a good slot that night. You know, so we want to kind of say thank you to our fans and give them as great of a show as we can. So, definitely looking forward to Rambling Man.
Are there particular tracks that you personally really love getting the chance to share with the fans live?
I think for me, I'm always kind of, I'm certainly proud of how some of the songs off the first album stand up. A song like Kingdom of the Lost, it doesn't matter what country we're in, what demographic the crowd is, there's something special about Kingdom of the Lost that it just resonates with everyone, young, old, rocker, metal, pop fan, whatever. You know, they're just fists in the air. So, you wish you could write one like that every time. But that song's been great. And the new songs, you know, Heavy Fire has been it's been blowing people away, which makes us feel great. A couple of the songs that are singles for us here in England, like Testifier, Say Goodbye, Dancing with the Wrong Girl, those are going over great as well.
The Golden Gods tonight, Black Sabbath. Can you guys quantify for each of you personally what Sabbath means to you? Because I think everyone has their own little story, their own memory of the first time they heard a record or what that band means to them.
You know, for me, I just remember when the first album came out, I was a kid. I'd never heard anything like that. I'd never seen artwork like that. It just, once I got past all my friends going, oh, that's really scary, it freaks me out, it didn't do that to me. It really kind of drew me in, lyrically, certainly sonically. I mean, Iommi influenced all of us. Any guitar player that walks through here and says that Tony Iommi wasn't an influence is a liar, because he influenced all of us, man. He's just the greatest of all time, so it's special.
I would just say they brought a whole new different way of playing the blues.